Hi, and welcome to a brand new series of creating web accessible HTML forms. In this series, we will develop web accessible HTML pages such as a login page, a signup page, a user dashboard, and a lot more. So make sure to subscribe to this channel to never miss a video. Today, we will focus on making a login page web accessible. In case you have not watched my previous videos on how to make HTML input elements web accessible, then I would encourage you to watch those videos as well. The link is in the description below. Hi, I'm Skill Singh, and on this channel, I help you build web accessible applications and share awesome UI and ADA tips. Now let's code together to make the login page web accessible. Alright, I have the HTML and the CSS ready for us to get in and make login page web accessible. You can find the complete code on my GitHub. Link is in the description. Let's quickly go over what we have in our login page. We have a couple of text boxes, a button, and a link. And looking at the HTML, I'm using the Bootstrap framework. So these classes are coming from the Bootstrap CSS. Also, I have a CSS class which is defined as base.css. This is where I have defined all the styling that you can see on this page. Let's go back to our HTML and start making our login page web accessible. Let's open up our DevTools and go to our xDevTool and run this. And when we ran this xDevTool by scanning the entire page, it's reporting only one issue. If you click on this, it will highlight the text box which is having the issue. There must be a label linked to this text box. Now, if you go back to our editor, the only thing missing is we have to link this label with this input. So what we can do is we can add an attribute for, and within this for, we have to pass this ID. So let's copy it over here and go back to our browser. Let me open up my editor and let's rerun this xDevTool. Now it's reporting zero issues. One interesting thing to note here is we have a label username and a corresponding input text, but these two input elements are not linked. But even then, xDevTool is not throwing any error, and that's because we are using a placeholder for this text box. Now, if I remove this placeholder, let's save this and rerun our xDevTool, it will report the same error. And the form element must have a label, and when I click on this, it will highlight the username text box. As a best practice, we should always have a for the labels which are linking to the text box or any control. The other benefit is if you go to your browser and click on the username, it will highlight the control. Similarly, if I click on password, it should highlight the text box password. Now, once we are done with the xDevTool, next step is to test all the accessibility issues manually. Tabbing is the first accessibility test that we must do. So just to check that all the controls and input elements are tabbable and are accessible while we are tabbing through. Tabbing should always work for the elements which are actionable, such as text boxes, drop downs, radio buttons, checkboxes, and links. In our case, all these elements are accessible using the tab key. Next, what we can do is we can add more meaningful content to these labels. For example, somebody who is running JAWS or NVIDIA screen reader, they will hear username and then this star. So let's make it more meaningful for the non-sighted users. Within this span, what we can do is we can add another span. We will give a class, we'll say screen reader only. And within this, we'll say is a required field. Now, whenever JAWS is running and the user is using tab, it will land on this text box. It will read username is a required field followed by the placeholder text. Let's do it for the password field as well. Let's copy this section and put it here, because both username and password are the required fields. There's one more thing that we can do. We can hide this star from being read by JAWS, and that we can achieve by using aria hidden equals to true. Within the span, we'll say aria hidden equals to true, and this should hold the value of star. We can do the same thing for the password field as well. We will run JAWS and have a listen for the entire page once we are done building a web accessible login page. I've created a very simple functionality that when user clicks on login, without entering data in any of these fields, we will display them an error messages. So let's go ahead and click on this. So we got a couple of errors. Please enter correct username and please enter correct password. These errors must be read by JAWS or a screen reader as soon as they appear on the page. And that we can achieve by adding role equals to alert. I have this div which is holding the list of the error messages that we received. On this div, we can add role, and role should be alert. The reason we are using role equals to alert is we want the end user to know about the errors as soon as they appear on the page, even though they are interacting with your web page or not. Next, when a user clicks on any of these error messages, it should link these errors to the text boxes. And for that, we have to use JavaScript. Now let's head to our index.js, which I'm referring here for this button, and write the JavaScript needed to make sure that when user clicks on this error message, it highlights or the focus moves to the linked control. Since these error messages are dynamically generated, we have to use the onClick event handler on the document itself. So let's go ahead and write the JavaScript. So I'll say we'll find the document, and for this I'll say on, and we have to find the click event. Now we have to specify on which element we want to define the click event handler for. I have this error div class, so let's copy this. I'll say dot error div. Within this error div, we need to find the anchor tag, okay, and then we have to write a function. Now let's click on this button to see the error messages. Let's inspect this element and find out what we have done for this anchor tag. Using JavaScript, I'm linking the text box and passing it as an attribute to this data attribute. So data hyphen linked element contains the text box ID. If I inspect the second element, we have data hyphen linked element as the txt password. So these two elements or these two hyperlinks are having a data attribute data linked element and are storing or are having a unique identifier. What we need to do is we need to find that attributes. Once a user clicks on any of the links, I'm using this identifier. Then we need to find the attribute that we just copied, and then this will have the actual value. So what we have to do is we have to find that identifier, and since we are using text boxes IDs, we have to use hash as an identifier, append it with the value that we received, and then put a focus on it. Let's save this. Let's fix the indentation. All right, let's save this and run this in our browser. We got the error message. Let's click on the second message. So my focus moved to the password text field. Similarly, if I click on this, please enter correct username, my focus is moving to the text box field. We missed one thing. Okay, whenever there is an error message, we are displaying the error message, which is right, but we also have to highlight the text boxes or the controls which are having the errors. To highlight this section with the red box or a red dashed box, we have to write a JavaScript. So let's go here and let's find this element first. So let's say dollar, and let's copy this from here. So we'll say we want to add a class to the parent so that both label and the text boxes can be handled at the same time. So let's find the parent, and to parent we want to add a class error. So let's save this, and when I click on this message login, it's displaying both username, label and the text box in red, with the text box having dash around it. This is helpful for people who are colorblind. They will be easily able to differentiate between an error state and a normal state. Let's have the same thing for our password field as well. Let's copy this list. Let's find the correct ID for the password. Let's save this. Go back to our browser, click on login page, and we are having this error. All right, we have made our login page web accessible by making sure that the tabbing is working correctly. There are no keyboard traps. Second, we added a meaningful label text. Third, we are making sure that the alerts are read as soon as they appear on the page. And finally, we are highlighting the controls which are having the errors by putting a red color to the label and a dashed border for the text boxes. Now I think it's high time that we run JAWS and have a listen.
Login form vertical bar web accessible. Page has one region, one heading and one link. Login.
On page load, JAWS read what is the page title, which is login form vertical bar web accessible, followed by how many regions are there and how many links are there on the page. Now let's start tabbing and see what it reads.
Username is a required field and it has pop-up. E.g. John. Type in text.
It's reading username is a required field, followed by E.g. John, which is the placeholder text. It also reads the helper text to let the user know what they can do with the text box. Let's go ahead and have a listen what it reads for the password.
Password is a required field, password edit. Type in text.
It's again reading password is a required field. And then since its type is password, it's signifying or letting the user know by reading it out. Let's go ahead and press enter on login without entering data and have a listen if it's reading out the alerts that we added or not.
Alert. Please enter correct username. Please enter correct password. Main region. Login button. To activate, press space bar.
So it's reading the error message as soon as it appears on the page. But there is one issue here. User should be able to go to the error message as soon as it appears so that they can click on it and go to the linked text box. That we can achieve by writing a simple JavaScript code, and let's do that. So we need to find the error that we just received and put a focus on it. So let's grab this element and I'll add it after this. So within this UL tag, we need to find the anchor tag which was having the issue. So let's find the anchor tag and simply add a focus, and that's it. Now let's refresh our page and have a listen by running JAWS.
Alert. Please enter correct username. Please enter correct password. Main region. Please enter correct username link. Enter. Autofill list box expanded.
Well, that's it. It's reading the error message as soon as it appeared on the page, and our focus moved to the first error message. And then when the user presses enter key, focus is moving to the linked control. In our case, it was a text box. Thanks for watching this video. Please do me a favor by smashing that thumbs up button and let me know your favorite social media login page in the comment section. Is it Facebook or Twitter? See you in the next video. Till then, keep coding.